Hello everyone, this is Kim, your, I'm gonna say favorite Oregon Duck soccer analyst, but I am your biggest fan who analyzes your Oregon Duck soccer games. And I am here with you to the end, regardless of anything that may ever happen. Now, I have been trying to analyze this Oregon versus Cal State game for when it was played. It's been so long, I can't even remember. I have been having problems with my streaming device since that time. And between that and my job and switching jobs within my job and looking for new jobs and trying to do other interviews and working on my other documentary that I'm working on, which if any Oregon Ducks happen to watch this, or any other athletes happen to watch this, I worked on the Invictus Games. I broke away. I took what equity I had, and I am doing a documentary on student athletes. If you would like to participate, please contact me. I'm willing to do it this way through Riverside. Through Zoom, I'm willing to fly out there. I am willing to do just about anything I can to accommodate you, to have you participate in what I think will be one of the most important documentaries of the decade after Title IX. So, to get back to this, Cal State. Now, I have to say this. The Oregon Ducks, it seems to me like every game they could have won. Literally, they could have won that game. And it seems like there was just some kind of cruel act in the universe that caused them not to win. And I don't know what happened. I'm not an organized religious person, so I can't really kind of go down that road. But it does seem like there just seems to be something out there, and I don't know what it was, because these women are so amazing and they play with so much heart and talent. I get to the point where I'm like, I don't even know what to say or how things happen anymore. I want to say that the Pac-12 refs are biased, and I do believe that they are to a certain extent, and I will get to that. I have it laid out so that it's a bit easier to when we put it into Adobe Premiere, that it's easier to move things around because it's all a process. I'm learning everything. As you know, I Oregon soccer is my passion, but I also do all sorts of other things along with it, which is why it's called Ramblings with Kim and not just Oregon Soccer with Kim. although that may just be a channel in the future. What can I say? I love you, women. So let's get on to Cal State. Off the bat, Ty Cortez assist to Kes Elmore for the goal. Less than 4 minutes. There we go. There's our one goal. One goal. Yes. And I haven't figured it out. Only one goal. And I'm sure that you women are the same way. It's like it's only one goal and then it's defense mode. And finally, when I was watching an Arizona game, I'm not going to touch on the first Arizona game. I'm going to touch on the second Arizona game. The first Arizona game, they're like that massive Oregon defense because it is. The women automatically move all the way down and they are in the box guarding that last third of the field. And I'm hoping that I can get that part out of the video before this because it was supposed to be shown. Because it is extremely impressive for everyone to run forward when they needed to, when they saw that they had an opportunity to get a goal. And then when they saw that the other team has the ball, they immediately collapsed back and they're on that last third and they are in that box, protecting that goal or protecting the goalie. And it is. And I am so happy that finally someone said something. Now, as I was saying, I want to say the Pac-12 refs are biased. And I think they still are. But I follow, Oregon Duck football, obviously. And that's the only reason I'm not going to be in Eugene to watch you play Oregon State because Oregon football just happens to be coming to Colorado. I don't know why. I don't know how. They just are. So we're taking the one opportunity to go watch them play. I know all you girls are so disappointed that I'm not going to make you hang out with me and hug me and you're all going to go, oh, great. Here's a crazy lady. Well, the crazy lady still is offering the unofficial, official, maybe it is, maybe it isn't. We're gonna do it, but maybe not do it. But y'all only have one game left, so I guess it really doesn't matter. Yellow card competition. And Chai Cortez, I think, accidentally pulled into the lead. And I promise, touch on that. I will be doing two more podcasts tonight because my husband has robots and I'm not allowed to go because every time I want it, I make suggestions for robots. They usually involve cats, like Bubble on top with my cat that would distract them, or knives, or maybe fire. I mean, they're all safe. They're all behind plastic. It's, robot wars. It seems to me like it should be legal. I mean, seriously, people, let's have some fun And so they don't let me play robots. I have to stay at home. So I'm going to do some more podcasts. And that's going to be one of the things that I touch on because, yes, this is a real thing. And it's a real thing, thanks in part to my lovely husband, who, because of me, gets to donate his money to all sorts of charities. And I believe in travel, and I think that's very important, but I'll get to that later. So we have the first goal out, Chai Cortez, perfect pass, Kes Elmore. She just smacks that ball into the back of the net. They don't know what's happened. And I'm like, yes, all we have to do is hold them off. And that's, I think, exactly what Oregon thinks. They get one goal defense the entire time, 1-0 game. And it doesn't work that way. But to show why this defense and this the way they play is so impressive. Is that there were in 11 minutes, there were three shots on goal by defenders. Anna Phillips, Belle Rowley, who has a leg on her, just like Jai Cortez. I haven't measured, so I don't. I haven't looked. Maybe I'll have to look at that to see. And Anna Imperdora. Imperdor. Oh, I'll get that. I know I'm doing better than the announcers. I'll give you that. And it was so frustrating because all I heard was Akeo and Lima. Akeo this, Alima that. Akeo this and Lima that. Lima this and Akeo that. And for all I heard of them, they couldn't score. They kept getting shut down. And I'm like, okay, but what about Zoe this, Oliche that, Anna this, Leah that, Chai this? Kes that. I know I'm missing more names. Oh, see, I do things like this. I think Air Force woman, and I forget her name because that's how I really relate things. To woman that that grew up in not Longmont, but the other L that lives is in Colorado, because that's how my mind thinks. And this is, please do not take offense to this. That's just the way that I relate to things. I have a person that I work with, and he has red hair, and you all probably don't remember this. There used to be this show with this guy that had this red, curly, floppy hair, and his name was Doug. My kids would talk about him, and I could never remember. I still have a hard time remembering his name, but I call him Doug because for my kids. His name is Abraham. Abe. But I always want to call him Doc. Okay. So please forgive me when I do that. I do not do it on purpose at any time. So I shoot. Yeah, I have a wireless keyboard and 30 different TV screens here. So let me go to Oregon Ducks and find the roster. And Lexi Romero. Yes. Still saying Space Force missed out on her. I don't know. Maybe she'll go into the Air Force after this. If she is going into the Air Force after this, contact me. We have contacts everywhere. We can get you just about any job you would like. Just saying. Yeah. And of course, the other person that she's from Highlands Ranch, Colorado, on Shanae Respass, of course. That's why I wanted to introduce myself to her father, because of course, we're still trying to get a professional soccer team here. And I have the backing of most of the people that I work with, which is about 150 people in this organization, which where they all work just above minimum wage. So that's pretty impressive, along with every blue candidate in Colorado. So we're making some progress here, women. We are. I'm hoping, even if Chai's out for a year or two, maybe she'll want to come back if we get a team. You never know. Megan Ruckers making waves. I have been watching her play defense. I mean, all of you. I Croy Soto. Oh my God. How did I miss her on my radar? How did I miss her? I don't know if it was just that, I was watching, my DNA so much and cheering for her and trying to get her into the game and get her the ball and tweeting about her that I missed so much and that Chai played a position similar to what I played. I missed so many good players. Caitlin Bakulba. Oh my God. And not only that, but oh, she'll hate me. I'm not gonna say that. Okay. Anna Phillips. Excellent defender. I mean, come on. Trinity Morales. She does both. Everybody does everything. I could go on and on. You women are all fabulous, okay? Let's just put it that way. You're all fabulous, but not are you just fabulous? You are the nicest people I have ever met. If you were willing to sit there and take the time out to make this old woman happy by saying hi, just, whatever, shake my hand. Like I said, check off the bus. And she has no idea how happy that made me feel. Or Zoe giving me a hug, looking at me like, who the fuck is this woman? But oh, thank you for coming to the game. I mean, that means a lot because you don't know who anyone is. You don't know who that person is. You don't know that that person might have the $40 million that's going to buy the next UWSL team. and might be looking more for people that have that winning personality, that go out and engage with the team, like Jerry Maguire. You just don't ever know. I may not look like it. So let's go on. All right. So then, of course, there's an obvious foul on Zoe. And she's on the ground. They don't give it to her. Where are we going from there? Then, okay, so then Chai gets a foul. I'm putting on my husband's ugly glasses because mine fell down a conveyor belt. We do not know what happened to them. They did not go down the conveyor belt. They did not go on the conveyor belt. They did not get crushed. They just disappeared because that's how weird the place is that I work. So there was a foul on Chai for no reason. And she got a yellow card just for running up behind someone from Cal. Now, maybe I'm wrong. I did not see her pull a jersey that time. I didn't see her do anything except running up behind her. Maybe I'm wrong. I will fully admit, if somebody tells me I'm wrong, I will fully sit here and say, yes, someone told me, no, that they did that. And I will sit there and in the next video, I will say, yes, I am wrong. Because in my next video, I will have to admit that I was wrong because I called, I told someone that I gave credit on Twitter to someone who got, I thought got the gold, but they didn't. Okay. So, then, now, I thought, okay, this was my favorite one. This is proof. This is really proof on how biased the Pac-12 refs are against Oregon. So Cal State gets called for going offsides. We all saw that, right? Cal State gets called for going offsides. And then they give them a free kick. And the actual ref's like, what's going on? And the other ref, the off, you know, the goal ref, or side, whatever he is, I can't think right now, it's like, he doesn't know. I don't think either one of them knew what was going on. And so they give Cal a free kick. And they still don't know what's going on. So they stop play and they give Cal another free kick on an offsides. Cal being offsides. What world, what soccer world do we live in?
Base. Offside. Offside flag is up. Minute. Oregon still leading 1-0 on Elmore's goal in the 4th minute. Great individual effort, and the finish was really pretty to beat Anderson. You know, initially the offside flag went up. Instead, it's going to be a free kick for Cal. Huh. Bears will take it. So here's a K.
Let's go!
play whistle dead? There's some confusion on everybody's part. So the clock continues to roll, as it seems like it's been taken forever to get this free kick off. Now we're going.
And that has happened so many times this year that I'm like, why don't we just start every single Oregon game with a PK? We'll just take everybody off the field. And we might as well take the goalie off, because only Utah was bad enough to not score on a PK. So we'll just take everybody off the field and we'll let them kick a PK and then we'll start the game. I think that's what we should do from now on. You know, I mean, of course, we only have one game left. I should have thought of this earlier. Hopefully next year won't be that way. But unfortunately, it's not going to work for the seniors this year. And the seniors deserve better than what they got. And I'm really mad. I am so mad. Do you have any idea how many times I have been on the phone with Pac-12? I mean, no, you probably don't, because it's not as many times as I was on the phone with the Dodds athletic director when we lived overseas and my daughter was running track and cross country and we had to deal with the worst coaches ever. And they did not know that I knew what I knew and that I was who I was. And it was bad. And even the athletic directors did not know what I knew. So they were having to call people stateside. They were having to call actual, like, cross-country professionals to find out if these techniques were right. And then they were calling me back and saying, yes, you're right. Oh, like, I know I'm right. Now go apologize to my daughter. My daughter's making all cross-country team, all European track team, all everything. And I'm like, you think you're going to get away with this, but you're not. And I'm not mentioning Oregon. I'm just mentioning this is going to stop. I'm using the clout that I have, just like I use it for charities, just like I use it for everything, politics, whatever. And I've been having the worst nightmares that I know is because of all this stuff that's going on. So there was a ball out of bounds. It was clearly out of bounds. Cal State kicks it back in. The same friggin' ref just is like, whatevs. Let's just keep going. It's all good. No worries. I'm going to mention only one of Leah's saves, because by now it's like, yeah, Leah, you're super amazing. What else were we going to say about you? I mean, you're like a Powerpuff Girl, saving the world before bedtime, right? You want to be the pink one? Or I can't remember. I'm the pink one. That's my profile. She makes an amazing save. It's a double save. So I'm showing that one on here for everybody. And I always credit Hofstra with Leapin' Leah. I can't remember what they call her now. Anyways, it was a great save. It was a wonderful save. So, then Chai has this flying block where she's just coming out of nowhere, and then she's just flying across the screen and blocks it. And then, of course, we have an amazing Chai corner kick. Now, you may ask me why I'm focusing so much on Chai this time. Professional soccer team. Yes. That's what I've been trying to do. I told you at the beginning of the year, it's going to be harder for some people to get onto a professional team if you do not have a winning season. I do not have a team yet. Otherwise, quite honestly, I take every single senior, except for probably Zoe, because I probably couldn't afford her. I'm not saying anything bad against the rest of seniors. Please don't think that way. But honestly, I don't know. I might be able to afford her. I think I probably have to dip into one of her 401ks. I don't know what she's going to go for on the market. I'd have to check. Maybe you'd all let me bundle you together like a T-Mobile plan. I take every single one of you seniors. I would. And the horrible thing is, this is what's so bad. And this is what's so frustrating on my end, is that, one, I'd probably steal your coach if I could. You didn't hear me say that, right? Okay. So I'd have a coach. We have infrastructure. State paid for it. The state of Colorado paid for it. Not the Switchbacks team, who can't fill the stadium and is constantly offering tickets half price or basically free. It's downtown where no one wants to go because it was mainly military that was going and military lives over here. I could use a stadium that is about as nice as the one that you women have now. It's not fabulous, but the overhead would be less, and it would be a start. But because my ancestors, okay, so we have infrastructure. They won't let just me use my money. It has to be a consortium. Now, the Switchbacks owner used only his money. He didn't have to have a consortium. So for me to get a consortium, then I went to my ex-boyfriend, who unfortunately his father passed away a couple years ago and his brother just passed away. Which left him a multi-hundred-million-dollar, well, a half-a-billion-dollar construction company. So we have a consortium of two. Apparently that's not good enough. He was born and raised in Colorado Springs. He's a multi-generational Coloradan. I am not. Apparently that consortium is not good enough. So apparently if there's anyone out there that has money that would like to invest in this team so we can get a big enough consortium, because they haven't told me how big this consortium needs to be, please let me know. We're a 501c3. And I think these ladies deserve it. Now, it has to be $40 million because it has to be a UWSL, not a NWSL, because Switchbacks is a USL. And because my ancestors saw the Rockies and said, oh, that's no problem. We'll climb those and we'll go all the way over to where we can't cross the ocean. And I am like, I don't know, a fourth or fifth generation Oregonian. That doesn't apparently work well in Colorado Springs. They want fourth or fifth generation. Coloradans. So I have one of those, but apparently they keep making up rules. So again, if you're interested in investing in a team that we have money for already, you're more than welcome to. And maybe if we have, I don't know, 1,000 people that invest in this team, they can't say no. Because no matter what I do, they keep saying no. And it's very difficult to say no to me. Now, it is midterms. So it's a little different, but yeah. It didn't happen that my immediate DNA's person that he married into decided to interfere in things she shouldn't interfere in, but not for the positive. I don't understand. Never understand anything. So we have the money. I'd love to take all of you ladies, every single senior, and put you on my team. And then we'll just fill it in with whoever from there, whoever the coach thinks should be on the team. And I've gone way too long. So I'm going to end with, let's fucking go and get this team on the road. I will be back later. You all have a wonderful rest of the day. This is Kim.